This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, in this video, we're going to go over the definitions of the six trigonometric functions. So here are the six functions. We have the sine, the cosine, the tangent, the cosecant, the secant, and the cotangent, and we're going to always use these three-letter abbreviations for those six functions. And we're going to be talking about taking the sine of an angle in this video. So keep in mind there is more than one way to define these six functions. Later we'll be talking about taking the sine of a real number, for instance, and there isn't just one way to express the trigonometric functions. But in this video, we're going to use what are called the trigonometric ratio definition. So from my previous videos or from some books you may have, you already need to be familiar with what the Pythagorean theorem is. And if you know that, you should be able to get the distance formula and to know what an angle and standard position is and what the terminal side of an angle is. Right, so here's our definition. We're not quite done with it. This is the setup. Suppose, right, see this little thing here? This is called alpha. So I'm going to use that symbol. I could have used a capital letter A. I could have used a different Greek letter, but I'm going to use alpha. So suppose alpha is an angle in standard position whose terminal side contains the point xy. So if you look at this picture, I've got the x and y plane. And this red line, right, red ray, actually kind of shows the terminal side of angle alpha. Alpha is in standard form because its initial side here is along the x-axis. So it's opening up here. And we're saying, all right, it contains the point xy. Now, you could put this a point anywhere along this red arrow. Okay, but let's say xy is right here. Like maybe that's the point 4, 3, who knows? So we've got this angle alpha, we have this point on the ray, and we're going to let the distance from the origin here to the point xy be r. All right, so r, that's how long that is. Now r must be a positive number because we're just talking about a distance. X and y, well, depending on what quadrant it's in, x could be positive or negative, and y could be positive or negative. In this picture, it's in the first quadrant, so x, y, and r are all positive. If you use the distance formula, if we just take this out for a minute, and we look at, let's say if this is the point x, y, then we know this length is x, this length is y, and if you did the Pythagorean theorem, remember that r squared equals x squared plus y squared. So if you take the square root of both sides, and we're talking about a length, so I don't need to put a negative sign in front of it. That's where I get that r squared is the square root of x squared plus y squared. So that's using the Pythagorean theorem, or you could use the distance formula. All right, so we've got the setup, we've got the picture. All right, so now how are we going to define the six trig functions? And here's how we do it. So our first one, there's no particular order, but I'm going to say, what is the sine of alpha? All right, so when you do a function, you're going to write the sine of the angle. And if you want, you could put it in parentheses, but that takes up a little bit more space. So if I just put sine alpha, it means the same thing as the sine of alpha. It's like writing f of x. Similar. Okay, but usually we'll just go ahead and write sine alpha. What does that equal? By definition, these are definitions, it's y over r. So whatever this value of y is, the y coordinate over the length, which happens to be r. The cosine of alpha is x over r, and the tangent of alpha is equal to y over x. So these are the ratios I was talking about. These are the main three functions. But There really are three other ones, so let's just get it to this part. So we have sine and cosine tangent. Those are the three main functions, but we also had the cosecant, and this was the abbreviation, cosecant, forgot to put the C. Cosecant of alpha is actually R over Y, and the secant of alpha was R over X, and the cotangent of alpha, see if I can get this just a little down, is actually X over Y. All right, now this is by definition. In other words, you say, well, where did this come from? Well, it'll hopefully make sense in a while, but for now, it's like you look in the dictionary, that's by definition what the sine of alpha means. Now, what I want you to notice, if you look at the sine of alpha and the cosecant of alpha down here, they're reciprocals. Notice the sine of alpha is y over r, but the cosecant is r over y. So these are called reciprocal functions. Reciprocal functions. Cosine of alpha is x over r, and the secant of alpha is r over x. So these two, cosine and secant, are called reciprocal functions. And the tangent of alpha is y over x. The cotangent is x over y. Now here's something that's a little confusing. It seems like, gosh, why is the sine kind of go along with the cosecant? It would be convenient if the cosine and the cosecant were reciprocals, but they're not. So this is something you have to basically memorize, that the sine of alpha is y over r. That's something you need to learn because it's a definition, and that the cosecant is r over y, or it's just the reciprocal of it. Okay, one of the things that you have to pay attention to is these are the functions as long as these are defined. Okay, so note, you cannot have a zero in the denominator. So these will be undefined if, for instance, let's say x was zero for some problem, then when you tried to get the tangent, you'd have a zero in the denominator, and then the tangent of alpha simply would not be defined, so it would be undefined. So as long as that doesn't happen, these are the six functions. So here we have the definition of the trigonometric functions. If x, y is any point other than the origin on the terminal side of an angle alpha in standard position and r equals the square root of x squared plus y squared, then here we go. The sine of alpha is y over r, the cosine of alpha is x over r, the tangent of alpha is y over x, and then we have the reciprocal identities here. The cosecant of alpha, that's the reciprocal of sine, r over y. The secant of alpha, that's the reciprocal of cosine, r over x. And the cotangent of alpha, that's the reciprocal of tangent, which is x over y. So we could write down those reciprocal identities like this. All right, so if we look up here, we see that the cosecant is the reciprocal of sine. So we can say the cosecant of alpha is really just 1 over the sine of alpha. And we could say that the secant of alpha is really just 1 over the cosine of alpha. And the cotangent of alpha is just the same as 1 over the tangent of alpha. Usually people like to think in terms of sine, cosine, and tangent, and that's exactly why I'm writing it this way. So that if you're looking for the cosecant, some people just think, oh, as long as I know what the sine is, I'll just do 1 over the sine, or the reciprocal of the sine. Okay, there's one other thing in here that's kind of interesting. Let's look at what the sine over the cosine equals. So here are our functions, right? And I wonder what is the sine of alpha over the cosine of alpha? Well, if you look up here, it says the way to define the sine is y over r, and the way that we define the cosine is x over r. And so what does that actually equal? That's y over r divided by x over r, right? Which is the same as y over r times the reciprocal of x over r, which is r over x, which is actually y over x. And then check it out, when you look up here, which one of these functions is y over x? It's right up here, it's the tangent. So that's another identity. The sine of alpha over the cosine of alpha. By the way, when you simplify it, it ends up being the tangent of alpha. All right, we'll do some problems now. So we'll actually take some angles and try to figure out the six trigonometric functions on the next video. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.